After a few months away, the GP4 OC News makes its welcome return for series number 9, meaning that we are one series away from a decade's worth of series. On top of this is the second time the new series will be covering the fantasy era, and if you thought 2021 was exciting enough, the changes coming for 2022 in terms of car physics and a new engine manufacturer should make things even more interesting. The 2022 sign-ups officially closed this past Saturday, meaning no more drivers can enter and no one can edit their choices. So whilst we wait for the first official news to break next week, let's take a look at what we know already, along with the latest rumours to dominate the paddock. The first thing that we know, and something that we alluded to earlier on, is the fact that there will be a new engine manufacturer on the grid in 2022, courtesy of BMW, who will be returning to the top class for the first time since 2009 when they partnered with Sauber to become the BMW manufacturer team. Back then, the series was using V8 engines. However, in 2022, it will be the first time the German manufacturer will be developing a V6 turbocharged hybrid. They will be partnering with McLaren in 2022, with the team being officially known next year as the BMW McLaren F1 team, which will be a partnership similar to the one McLaren had with Honda from 2015 to 2017 and the one they had with Mercedes from 2006 to 2009. McLaren, as a result, will be splitting with Renault at the end of the 2021 season after only 3 seasons with the French manufacturer, and will be hoping the partnership with BMW will be similar to the one they had with Mercedes rather than the one they had with Honda. As a result of BMW entering, it will mean there will be 6 engine manufacturers on the grid, as they will be joining Mercedes, Ferrari, Honda, Renault and Lamborghini as manufacturers who are developing engines in the top class. It will be interesting to see how BMW does in their first season back. On the topic of engines, McLaren are not the only team to be switching engine suppliers next season, as when the 2022 sign-up opened, it was revealed that Williams would be splitting up with Mercedes at the end of the 2021 season after 8 seasons using the German manufacturer, and will be officially switching to Lamborghini engines from 2022. The switch to Lambo engines will make them the first team outside of the Lamborghini F1 team to be supplied by the Italian manufacturer in GP4OC. Lamborghini's impressive rookie season in the top class caught the attention of Williams, which led to them becoming their first customer team. Williams will be hoping the switch to Lamborghini engines will move them further up the grid in 2022, and it will be interesting to see if any other teams follow suit in the future. The third thing we know is the fact that the car physics for 2022 will slightly change, with changes aimed at 2 specific things. Firstly, the cars will become a little bit more draggy in 2022, with the hope of increasing more slipstream, which should lead to more overtakes. And secondly, the rear tyre grip on the cars will be slightly reduced, with the aim of making them a little bit more lively on the rear, which should in turn lead to the cars being a little bit more prone to oversteer. Top class host Yuri has indicated there could be subtle changes to the car physics for future seasons to try and freshen up the series a little bit every season in order to not make the cars too stale and predictable. The final thing we know about is the 2022 provisional calendar for the top class, which got revealed this past Sunday. It will once again feature 21 races just like the previous 6 seasons, including this one, but it has come with some major changes. The first change is the position on the calendar for the Korean and Portuguese Grand Prix. In 2021, the Portuguese Grand Prix hosted round 5 and the Korean Grand Prix is scheduled to host round 15. However, in 2022, Korea has been pushed forward to become the third race of the season after the Chinese Grand Prix, whilst the Portuguese Grand Prix has been pushed back to round 14 and in turn will become the final European race of the season. However, the biggest changes that people would have noticed is the fact that the Monaco and Brazilian Grand Prix are not on the calendar, with Brazil being the most surprising one, and have been replaced by 2 new venues. Monaco has been removed from the calendar as a result of having its cornerstone status removed, and will only be allowed to return to the top class in the future if there is a workable and raceable version of the current version. Meanwhile, Yuri has alluded that the Brazilian Grand Prix could make a return as early as 2023, however on this occasion, due to the system he has which determines the calendar, it has been removed for at least 2022. This means as a result, Brazil will not host the top class finale for the first ever time, and the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix at the Yas Marina circuit will become the new final round. In terms of the 2 new venues, Misano will make its top class debut in 2022, hosting round 5 after successful track testing and successful races in DTM, and will revive the San Marino Grand Prix, making it the first San Marino Grand Prix since 2006 when it was at Imola. But the one that everyone is talking about is the first ever Argentine Grand Prix, which will host the penultimate round of the season. The Grand Prix will take place at the Autódromo Juan Manuel Fangio, named after the great man himself, and is located in the city of Balcarce, which is in the province of Buenos Aires. After failed attempts at getting a race at the Autódromo Juan y Oscar Gálvez in Buenos Aires, a test race at Balcarce was held and it turned out to be successful. And so finally, after many failed attempts, an Argentine Grand Prix will finally be on the top class calendar, meaning that Franco López, providing he gets a seat, will finally have a home Grand Prix next season. It will be interesting to see how Mazzano and Balcarce do in their debut seasons. And they are all the things that we know about. So with those out of the way, let's look at this season's pick order and go through some of the rumours to dominate the paddock. For starters, here is the pick order for this year's silly season. Before the silly season began, there was a rule change to the pick order, which stated that if there were any drivers that signed up who had never competed in any series available in GP4OC before, they would not be counted towards the pick order. There were a lot of ties in this season's pick order, which, as per usual, were determined by the number of overall pricks, providing that they had competed in the OC in some capacity before. Haas had the most number 1 picks with 12, followed by Alfa Romeo and Aston Martin, who were both tied on 7. Williams were 4th with 5, followed by Renault, AlphaTauri, Ferrari and McLaren, who were all tied on 4. Then there was a three-way tie at the bottom with Lamborghini, Red Bull and Mercedes all tied on 3. The pick order will also be posted on Discord later on tonight, but with that out of the way, let's get on with the rumours. According to Yuri, he believes that this year's silly season could be the most straightforward, with a total of 6 teams on a scale of likely to most likely being likely to retain their 2021 lineup into 2022. Too many likelies in that one sentence, I know. These teams being Mercedes with Franco López and Armand Carr, McLaren with Kirishima DeRosa and Joseph Willows, although if one of them drops the ball, then FE champion and F2 championship contender Agatina Bavona and FE title contender Brandon Jackson could be there to capitalise. AlphaTauri with David Kupok and Miklos Gao, with many people believing at one stage that David would try and have a go at the vacant Red Bull seat, Ferrari with Chris Chatfield and Jake Galloway, Williams with Felix Sontag and Jamie Griffiths, although DTM title contender Mohamed Usman Hamid could be there to capitalise if Griffiths' performance starts to drop off, and Lamborghini with Rahul Patel and Laura Chung. The other 5 teams could slash will be looking at least 1 or 2 changes in their lineup. We'll first look at the biggest one of them all, which is of course Red Bull. As we know by now, back at the Portuguese Grand Prix, it was announced that current championship leader Franco Gamba would be retiring from the top class at the end of the season, with him looking to move to another series. This as a result meant that there would be at least 1 vacant seat available at Red Bull for 2022, but the question is, who will be the one to replace him? As we alluded to earlier, before the silly season began, a lot of people believed that David Kupac would end up being a contender for that vacant Red Bull seat. However, in the end, he opted to put his current team AlphaTauri as his first choice. It is now believed that current Renault driver Evan Byrne is looking to be the favourite to replace Franco Gamba at the team next season, as a result of the Irish driver announcing back at the Austrian Grand Prix that he would be leaving Renault at the end of the season after a frustrating 5 seasons with the French manufacturer. He has not put Renault at all in his choices, confirming that he will not be with the team next season. In terms of George Rowe, it is looking likely that he will remain with the team for another season, despite a shaky return to the team so far. Meanwhile, at Aston Martin, both of those seats could become interesting. Roland Motrin could remain at the team for another season, however, due to a few poor performances this season, he could get dropped. In terms of his teammate Julius Anderson, it's a completely different story, as it is looking likely that he'll be leaving the team at the end of the season due to him putting another team down as his number one choice, with that team being behind Aston Martin in the pick order. In terms of who could be in the frame to replace Julius Anderson and potentially Roland Motrin, they range from 3 different candidates. They are the team's current test driver and 2020 GP2 champion Aaron Curtis, current F2 championship leader Tobias Kress, and current Alfa Romeo driver Andre Vidieri, who is looking likely to be leaving Alfa Romeo at the end of the season due to Alfa Romeo being ahead of Aston Martin in the pick order. It will be fascinating to see what the lineup will be at Aston Martin in 2022. Meanwhile at Renault, and as we established earlier, Evan Byrne will be leaving the team at the end of the season due to a frustrating few seasons with the team, meaning there will be at least 1 vacant seat at Renault next season, given it's looking more likely that Jesus Perrinen will be retained by the team after an impressive rookie season in 2021. 2 drivers are more likely to be in the frame for the second Renault seat. These being current Alfa Romeo driver Roman Quagg, who actually put Renault as his number one choice for the 2021 season, only to miss out to Jesus Perrinen and end up at Alfa Romeo, and current Aston Martin driver Julius Anderson, who is more likely to leave the Silverstone-based team at the end of the season. Cue the memes, everyone. It'll be interesting to see who Renault end up choosing to partner alongside Jesus Perrinen should the Spaniard be retained. Moving on to Alfa Romeo, and it is highly likely that the Sauberan Swiss team will end up with a new lineup in 2022, given that Roman Quagg has put Renault as his number one choice, which is behind Alfa Romeo in the pick order, and the fact that Andre Vidieri has put Aston Martin as his first choice, which is also behind Alfa Romeo. A number of contenders could be in the frame for both of those Alfa Romeo seats. One of these contenders includes current Haas driver Amelia Walser, who will be entering her final season in 2022 providing she gets a seat before her two-season sabbatical, as it is looking more likely that she will not spend her final season with Haas given that Haas are ahead of Alfa Romeo in the pick order. Other contenders include current F2 drivers Bent Valdinger, Alexander Arnold and Ruslan Proksiuk, DTM driver and former MANA driver Maxim Titkov, and current FE driver Jake Tilsley. FE Championship contender Robert Ionescu could also be in the frame for an Alfa Romeo drive, however he has another team as his number one choice, which he is also a contender for. There is also another driver who could be in contention for Alfa Romeo if his number one choice fails, but we will get onto that later. The final team we will look at is Haas, who have the most number one picks with 12. Current Haas driver Daniel Fraser is looking likely to remain at the team for another season after what has been a much improved 2021 season for the Brit. However, as we alluded to earlier, it is looking more likely that he will once again have a new teammate, as it is looking more likely that Amelia Walser will leave the team at the end of the season as a result of her putting Alfa Romeo down as her number one choice, which is behind Haas in the pick order. In terms of who could replace her at Haas, there are a number of contenders, which range from the team's current test driver Bartosz Kloss, who is currently competing in World Champ Car for Team Penske, fellow World Champ Car driver Nicholas Zorbach, who is having a redemption season in 2021, current FE Championship contender Robert Ionescu, and the one which has raised many people's eyebrows, Florian Völker. Yes, the five-time world champion could be making an unexpected return to the top class in 2021 after a brilliant season in the midfield Arrow McLaren SP. He also has Alfa Romeo as his second choice in case Haas doesn't work out for him. However, just like with Haas, he will have tough competition to overcome if he wants to return to the top class. It will be interesting to see which direction Haas end up going in. And they are all the rumours to dominate the paddock. And with that, that concludes the pilot episode for the GP4 OC News Series 9. The first team news of the season will break next week at the Belgian Grand Prix in Spa-Francorchamps. Who will be the first driver or drivers to be announced? Tune in to Tuesday's practice session next week at the Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps in Stavelot.